this semifinal match. Good crowd here once again for the Pro Bowlers Classic.
Should be exciting. Got four fine teams left here in the elimination tournament. It's a nice one to start with, 7-10.
Yeah.
He's got some wood here, though. Rosario, much like Mike Sargent, been around the game long enough so they know how to play this wood. Now he's got no choice.
Waited for the wood and one of the pieces rolled off, so that was his only alternative. Rosario and his partner Shelly Borowski beat Tom Olsta and Anita Fournier 450-369 4 weeks ago in our first quarterfinal match. Rosario switching over now to lane 31 for his second frame. And no split this time.
I don't look like he's going to be left with a 5-10. Trip the 10 out, leaving a solid 5 for a spare. No.
Missed it.
Pulled it to the left.
Knew as soon as he let it go.
Rosie would give us one of those Italian phrases, but
pair of nines, and that brings up Mike Sargent.
This is much like they started the last match, and then they caught fire. Rosario and Shelly, they were just unbelievable from about the 6th box on the first string.
And Mike is a little off target.
Up the 2-4-6, looking for 9 or 10, and clears out the 2 and the 4 for a 9 box. Both teams looking for the first mark.
Bury it, Michael, bury it.
And he's got another shot at 2-4-6.
Mike Sargent and his partner Mary Ligenza had to go to 2 extra frames last week in our last quarterfinal to knock off Tim Lidke and Julie Fodden. What a match that was. That was a great match.
Certainly was.
I think it took the bowlers about 15 minutes to calm down after the show was over.
Yeah.
It was pretty nerve-wracking.
Wind down. Yeah.
Shelly Borowski, Rosario Lechiara's partner.
Down on the 3 and the 6. Mentioned in the opening of the show that Shelly bowled extremely well last time. Between the two of them, they might have missed one what I call legitimate spare, but I just can't remember it.
Shelly had 8 marks in the quarterfinal. Remember, that's only in 14 boxes.
is an incredible score for anyone to hit, but to hit it in mixed doubles and then the Scotch doubles format where your partner fills your marks unless it's the last frame of the string, it's just incredible to see somebody hit 450 that way.
Rosario and Shelly had strings of 154, 132, and then they finished up with a 164. And in that 164, they only had 2 open boxes.
Shelly leaves herself an interesting shot. She's got the 4-9-10. She's got to go down possibly on the wood in front of the 4. Have the ball carry him off in towards the 9 and the 10. Nice shot.
First mark of the match.
And it was a good one, too.
Come on, Mary.
Come on, let's go right here.
And that will bring up Mary Ligenza. Mary will have a spare leave on the 2-4.
Oh, sliding to the
four marks in the quarterfinal match against Lipke and Frotten. Now working opposite that spare in the fourth.
Hammer, Mary, hammer.
Mary throws the ball extremely hard for a woman. One of the harder throwing women on the pro tour.
All four of these bowlers with a lot of experience on the tour. Shelly is the rookie comparatively of the four, and she's been on the tour 9 years, so it gives you an idea. And that'll be a six for Mary. Carol Downey working the big scoreboard this week. Next week, she won't be able to.
No.
She's had to find somebody else because Carol will be with her partner, Mike Poulin, in the other semifinal against Jack Ray and Sharon Rawson.
Now Rosario fills the spare that his partner, Shelly, got, and he goes flush on the head pin, chops out just the one and the five.
Rosario had 11 marks in the quarterfinal match. That's 11 marks in 16 boxes, remember?
And he did well to work out with the nine in that box after jump out the one and the five on the spare. Very important, even if you get a bad fill on a spare, to try to get that 9 or 10 box, so at least you're making that spare count, meaning you're getting over 20 pins in the two boxes.
Better looking ball that time for Rosario, and will it go? No, it won't.
These are the four rocking back and forth. Four pin for a spare.
First mark for Rosario, second for the team. Again, the two losing teams in the semifinals, this week's show and next week's show, will each split $500 prize money. And then 2 weeks from today in the championship match, the runners-up will split $750, and the champions will split $1,000.
Still Sargent and Ligenza looking for their first mark.
And Mike will have a nine pin. Michael had 8 marks in the quarterfinal match last week. And there's one there, his first of the day. Shelly Borowski crossing over, and she'll have a spare leave and an 8 fill.
It's good fill in Rosario's spare. Leaves herself the 4 and the 8. And the way the wood is positioned, it's not going to help her too much if she's not on the 4 pin.
See, Shelly had a very successful 1984 on the tour.
Hold it to the right. Shelly's really come into her own the last couple of years. She's going extremely well. Constantly in the money in the Pro Tour, and currently is ranked in the top 10.
Seven will go, but four will stay, and this won't be easy.
No, try to split the 3 and the 6. Although many bowlers in this place have such great sidewall action here, even could go inside in the 3 into the 6 and come off the wall with them. She's trying to split it. Didn't miss that by much.
And again she went for it, and that time she converted it for a 10.
Didn't miss it much the first ball. Or, I mean, the second ball in the spare, I mean. She clipped it that time for the 10.
Come on, Mary.
Nice shot.
Mary Ligenza missing the head pin, but it may turn out all right.
Looked like she was going to have the 1-3-6 left. The wood came back and clipped the 6 into the 3. And you see the replay. Almost, it looked like a hit for a half Worcester. 1-3-6 go down. And it was on a spare also.
Mary now filling the strike in the 7th. Hoping to escape here a little bit.
Little pull, but good fill on the strike.
Gives Mary and Mike the lead again. By 5 pins with 2 boxes remaining in this first string. Rosario Lechiara.
Right, just a little heavy on the head pin, and what happens when you do that a lot of times is you hit the 1 heavy, hit the 3, and the 3 goes around the 6 to clear the 10 and not touch the 6 pin for the spear.
Well, the team of Lechiara and Borowski pinning well. Right in the pocket that time, no doubt.
Ball crosses over into the 1-3. It's a backup ball over. His ball breaks a little bit from left to right. And for the strike, and because it's the last frame, Rosario will fill his own mark here, his own strike.
Almost the same ball, but he was a little bit farther off to the right. And that results in the 5-8.
A little light that time.
No problem with the spare, and 20 in the 10th for the team, and they salvage a 1-17.
Come on, Michael. Mike, right in now.
Mike Sargent will need at least one mark to get even here.
Go at it, Mike. Go get it.
2, 4, 5, and 7 for the spare. No, this is the object being the 2.
Michael, bury it.
Right in the pocket.
Ball. That's
and
gone.
That should go, yes.
Just enough off the side while that pin was rolling. And just enough to clip the 5. Here's the replay. 1-2 pocket. Wood comes rolling off the sidewall. Just hard enough.
Mike filling it. High hit. But he almost got the double.
And that time he was right on full on the head pin, right on the nose. This ball's explosive, though.
20 apiece. Well, took till the 10th box, but things got a little hot in the 10th. And after one string here in the Pro Bowlers Classic semifinals, the first of 2, Mike Sargent and Mary Ligenza with a 1-20, Rosario Lechiara, Shelly Borowski with a 1-17. String number 2 and details in our home contest when we come back. Don't go away. Well, again, here is how you enter our home contest. If you'd like to get in on our weekly jackpot, which is incidentally is up to $20 at the end of this week's show, send postcards only with your name and address and a number from 1 to 10 and send them to contest. Sandy's Bowling Lanes, Route 28, Windham, New Hampshire, 03087. That number corresponds to the number of pins you think will be knocked down by our winning bowler every week. And if the number on your card matches the number of pins dropped and we draw your card, then you win whatever's accumulated in the jackpot. And if you don't match, you do get a consolation prize, a TV50 NHCBA desk pen. So we hope you get those postcards in. And thank you for all the mail, by the way. We've been starting a new system lately where we empty the box after each winner. And so that increases the mail, it seems, and get everybody a chance to win. So we're about ready to start string number two, and Mary Ligenza will get it going for us. And that's how to start it.
No doubt about that one. Ball hooks a little bit from right to left, and she just buried that in the 1-3 pocket. There's just no way those pins are going to stand up. Nice ball. Ooh, this time she gets away from us.
Well, better on a strike than on a spare.
Right.
For Mary. Still has time to recover. Mary has two marks at both strikes.
That's better.
That's the recovery.
I think that first ball just got away from her a little bit.
Looks just like a nine, Phil, on the scoreboard. A nine first ball, rather.
Sometimes she picks on the 1-2 pocket and clears out the other nine pins.
Looks just as good as a nine drop and a single pickup. Shelly Borowski with some work.
Looks like the same lead that Rosario started with when he bowled the first box of the first frame. She's got to be on the five pin and hope she gets some help out of the wood leaning against the five. Almost off going, missing the five and clipping the end of that wood, but still would have needed some help for the seven. Interesting choice there. You know, left-handers usually like to go for the 10-pin as opposed to the 7. Shelly took, her choice was to go for the 7-pin for the 9-pin, for the 9 box.
Shelly from Dedham, Mass.
Oh, boy. A lot better than that.
First the 5, 7, 10, and now the 4, 6, 7, 10.
I really don't know here. I probably go down 6 and 10, try to move that wood over.
Looks good.
Oh,
looked like it might have been better than that.
It's a nice try. Real difficult shot to make.
Going for another one of those cut shots. Takes an 8, though. That brings up Mike Sargent, who'll be working on Mary Ligenza's spare in the second.
Bury it, Michael, bury it.
Six pin.
9 fill on the spare, leaving the 6 for another spare.
Three marks in a row for the team.
Right on the 6, no doubt about it. 3 in a row. Strike and 2 spares.
Another 6 pin.
Another solid 6 pin. Not this time.
Rosario Lechiara.
Pull on the head pin, wants to see that 4 to go down, and it does. Leave himself at 3, 6, 10 for the spare. Covers for the spare. Splits the 3 and the 6. And you get that domino effect right down to the 10. Another good fill. This match a long ways from home.
Mike Sargent and Mary Ligenza had a three-pin lead coming in, and they've extended that lead, that string of marks, but two important ones there for Rosario Lechiara, and we will take a timeout right here, as once again the marks are starting to pile up. Rosario Lechiara and Shelly Borowski at 35 with a spare up in the fourth. Mike Sargent and Mary Ligenza at 68 through four, and as we look at the form of Rosario Lechiara, we'll be back after these messages.
Who has transformed a raw idea into a brilliant new dimension of sight and sound?
Dementia.
Only RCA. Introducing the Dementia system. The only video audio component system that is totally intelligent, totally interactive, totally incredible. And you can build it component by component.
Dementia.
One remote control governs all of Dementia's seven separate components. Video monitor. Amplifier. VCR, digital audio disc, stereo tuner, stereo turntable, and stereo cassette. And every audio and video function is displayed right on the TV screen, making a simply incredible system incredibly simple. The next dimension in sight and sound, only from RCA, technology that excites the senses.
Now available at P.E. Fletcher, 331 Main Street, Nashua.
And now a message from Richard E. Diamond, president of the David Edwin Corporation.
To gain your confidence with put-on-print promises is not our way of doing business. We achieved our success in the copier and typewriter industry by backing our products with three simple words: price, reliability, service. Nothing else matters.
Call now to lease an Adler electronic memory typewriter for as little as $39.98 per month with minimum deposit. For a free demonstration in your office, call David Edwin. Where we're not number one, you are.
At Budget Rent-A-Car, Rent-A-Truck, we rent and lease all types of vehicles at budget rates. There's a large variety of dependable late model trucks and vans, including 15 passenger vans for private and commercial use, most with automatic transmission and with ramps, hand trucks, dollies, and pads available. In our trucks, to meet your budget with our low rates by the day, week, or month, or with our special mini lease packages.
When you need a truck and are on a budget, call Budget Rent-A-Truck.
Mary Ligenza, fifth frame, second string.
Come on, Mary.
Okay, Mary.
Right back at him, Mary.
A little heavy on the head pin, but not a bad lead. Well, it's going to be a tough one. He's going to come up high in that wood, turn it, push it back, or go real low on the right-hand tip and have it come off the sidewall. He's going to have trouble carrying the eight pin.
Just
high enough to cover the eight. That's the one I was worried about.
Bury it, Mary. Bury it right here.
Just enough to clip that eight.
Just a five, Phil, and a rather ugly-looking five at that.
She just left that ball to the right of the head pin. She lofted the ball out in lane a little further than she usually does. Consequently, it didn't have time to break. She left it to the right.
An 83 half for the team, Sargent Ligenza. Shelly Borowski to work on Rosario Lechiara's spare there in the fourth.
Seven.
Doesn't seem to matter what Shelly does. She ends up with a split.
6-7. I think her only shot would be to try to cut the 6 over. Hard throw like the two men, and maybe even Mary might try the wood and have it come off the wall, but got to go for the cut shot.
Now the lead is 24 through the fifth box, halfway through.
Another nice looking ball.
Boy, oh boy.
he throws from left to right, he's a left-hander, and that ball goes in the 1-3 pocket, hits the pins and goes immediately to the right sidewall, so the ball's not helping her when she comes through. She doesn't throw that hard, so she's got to come in the 1-2 pocket so that ball can help her cutting through the pins. Oh, nice try.
Nope, it's not going to go. Right at it. Mike Sargent gets the five, the seven will stay.
Let's see how Mike attacks this one. Now he just missed a six pin for a spare a couple boxes ago, but the veteran that Mike is, he probably forgot all about that one.
I know, he's waiting for the wood to settle down. He's got a couple of pieces down there, but he's going to go right at it.
And he covers.
A light hit, but moved the six pin about 2 inches.
It was real light. A lot of action on that ball. Gets those pins moving. Be any problem here.
Fifth mark of the match for Mike Sargent. The ninth for the team. And Rosario Lechiara answers back.
It's back with a strike. Here's the replay. Ball breaking a little bit back to the right, kind of heavy on the head pin. Moves out the 6 and 10, and then eventually the 2 and the 4. And he's a little light this time, like Mike was, but he's getting a lot of action, too. 7-8 for another spare. Double piece of wood should snap towards the 7. He wanted to go down closer to the 7.
As he covers it for the 10. Mary Ligenza now to fill the mark left by her partner, Mike Sargent. Mary has 4 marks of her own already. Again, bowling exceptionally well.
Oh, boy. That's the difference between Mary and Shelly. Mary throws that much harder. That way she didn't hit her pocket either. She crossed over the 1-2. Because she throws a little harder, those pins react a little differently.
Oh.
Hit the wood and didn't cover the 10 pin. So she can get away with throwing it on the opposite side. Shelly, slower ball, she needs all the help she can get. So she's got to be in the 1-2 pocket to score real well.
Looking at a chance at a 150 game on the mark here in the 10th.
Four horsemen right, plus the 7 pin.
Well, this is going to leave 2 open frames for Shelly Borowski to work against. But a 148 second game for the team of Sargent and Ligenza.
Next one fills too. 10, 9, 9, 5, 7, and 9. There's Shelly's part. She's in the 1-2 that time. Leaves herself to 3, 6, and 9 for a spare leaf. She's got some wood in between the 5 and the 9. Looks good. Oh, wood killed it. Wood killed it in between.
light this time, but not a bad leave. It's going to be the 3-9.
Again, she's in that 1-2 pocket. Seems if she hits that pocket, she gets a spare leave.
Have to drive through this one, and does.
It's been bowling much better than the score indicates sometimes. Why don't she hit that last spare, too, in the ninth, and then carry it.
Looking for a big pill, crosses over.
And again, she crosses over in that 1-3. It's not helping her, that ball.
A 6 and a 1-27. So, after 2, Carol Downey puts him up on the board. Mike Sargent and Mary Ligenza with a 2-68. And Rosario Lechiara and Shelly Borowski with a 2-44. The lead is 24 with one string remaining. We'll be back with that third and deciding string here on the WCBC Pro Bowlers Classic next. Don't go away. Third string set to go. Rosario Lechiara, Shelly Borowski trailing by 24 pins. As Rosie starts it off with a spare leave.
And 2-5. Moves go way left.
Reminder that for those of you who'd like to see Candlepin Stars and Strikes, that is as it is actually being videotaped, you can join us next week here at Sandy's, our next taping, Sunday, April 14th. We usually start about 10 in the morning and go all day long, and we'll have a brand new ladder series, 6 brand new bowlers for that taping next week. Reminds me that we're just 3 weeks away now from the match that has just captured the imagination of at least 2 or 3 people. Dandy at Sandy's. Dan and I will be bowling against each other 3 weeks from today. We figured that was the only way we could follow up the championship match of the Pro Bowlers Classic.
Right.
And also, in reality, all kidding aside, it is our first anniversary show, so
right.
That makes it kind of special, too.
Bury it, Michael, bury it!
A spare for Mike Sargent to start it off here in the third string.
Yeah, they're smoking right now. Another solid 6 pins. 3 or 4 times Mike has left that for a spare. And he covers it. And that's going to put the left pressure on Rosario Lechiara and Shelly Borowski. They're down 24 pins coming into the game.
Five, six, ten.
Got a piece of wood just to the left of the 5 pin. Try to play the wood on the red line. Got a chance of it sweeping across into the 5 and then covering the other 2.
Like that.
Nice shot.
Third mark of the day for Shelly Borowski, and worth taking another look.
She's right on the red line. Into the 5 and 6 and the 10. And again, in the 1 and 2 pocket.
5-pin sliding over is going to make this an even tougher shot. Although she does have a couple of pieces of wood there.
3, 5, 9, and 10. Got to be on the 3.
Yeah. Very nicely done. That was a pretty shot by Shelly Borowski. And we'll have a look at that one again.
She's been bowling well. She's been bowling well, and finally the marks are starting to come her way. Split the 3 and the 5 off the wall, covering the 10 and the 9.
Fourth mark of the day for Shelly, and now Mary Ligenza working on two spares in a row by her partner.
Get away with it, Mary. Bring it in. Come on.
Fills that one with a six. Mentioned Carol Downey is working the big scoreboard for us today. Our lob line judge is Paul Wambach.
Paul is a member of our executive board in the World Candlepin Bowlers Congress, as is one of the contestants today, Shelly Borowski.
Target, and that doesn't look too pretty at all.
No, Paul's going to have to check that piece of wood out in front, and he said it's okay. Better with it than without it, but
that's right.
8, 9, and 10. Tough shot. I think she was playing that wood and pulled a little bit to the left.
Just say, going for the cut shot there.
Yeah.
The
That's what she wanted to do. And
wasn't there anyway. An 8 box for Mary, and we will pause right here. 51 through 4 for the team of Sargent and Ligenza. Lechiara and Borowski trying to come from behind. 33 and a spare up in the fourth. More WCBC Pro Bowlers Classic action right after these messages.
New Hampshire's newest and largest, the Londonderry Bowling Center, just minutes away from Derry, Manchester, Nashua, and the North Shore. 32 lanes where the youngsters and the young at heart can enjoy the satisfaction of strikes, spares, and the misses that sometimes happen. And for lunch, dinner, or after bowling refreshment, there's TR's. A fun place with a DJ 7 nights a week. You'll love TR's, great food, and the pizza is something else. And you'll love the bowling, too. Londonderry Bowling Center and TR's. Orchard View Drive, Londonderry, New Hampshire, where the action is.
Rosario Lechiara will work on that second of two spares left by his partner, Shelly Borowski, and the team needs to continue marking because they trail by 24 coming in, and the boxes are starting to run short.
It looked a little better than that. Rosie had a quick reaction to that, too. He looked like he deserved more. Looked like a pretty good hit. Left cluster five on the left. 2, 4, 5, 7, and 8.
Oh, yeah. Well, he would have liked a better fill, but the important thing is he's got a chance for another one on that nice shot.
He's heavy on the two pin, too. Clears out the 5 and the 7.
Sixth mark for Rosie, 10th for the team. Full, but some wood may help.
4, 7, and 10. I use that wood between the 4 and the 7, in front of the 4 and the 7. Almost. Possibly go on the cap between the 4 and the 7 and play both pieces of wood. Let's see what he elects to do. Not pie. Nope.
It looked like more would happen there, but. The 9 for Rosie. He's up, Mike Sargent.
Hammer, Michael, hammer.
Well, the 5 pin is going to stick around.
Boy, he's thrown a lot of solid 9 pin drops.
No doubt about that one.
No. Got a lot of confidence right now, and he's bowling well.
Get him, Michael.
8th mark for Mike Sargent, 12th for the team.
Oh,
Mike thought he had him all that time, I think.
How dare you two stand up?
Had his arms raised in the Rocky tradition, and
6-9. Making things tough for Shelly and Rosario.
Shelly Borowski for her final two.
Leaving the 2 and the 4. down to must marks now. They've got to string a few together. Any hopes of pulling this one out? No, she left it to the left.
Nine box for Shelly. Team needed that one. Maybe a little bit too late, though.
Well, there's always the possibility. She's right in that 1-2 pocket. Always a possibility of throwing that double strike, and that could turn things around.
Harry Ligenza gets a break on the 4-7.
Going to need a double. She keeps throwing marks like that. She leaves herself the 6-10 for another spare. The object pin being the 6. Flipped the 6 and fell into the 10 for the spare.
Tough to catch up when the other team keeps marking.
Right. Lead's going to be up close to 40 pins. Over 40 pins now. Rosie's going to have to throw a double strike.
Oh, what a shot that was by Mary Ligenza, and she'll wrap up her activities for the day with 6 marks, and that was a beauty.
1, 3, 7, 8, and 10. Splits the 1 and the 3. Fine shot.
That's 15 marks for the team.
Come on, 15 out of 30 boxes. Not bad. Not bad at all.
And they got room for 2 more, at least.
And I think that's just about going to do it.
Seems almost certain now that Sargent and Ligenza will have a 400 triple. They needed a 132 coming in, and they don't even need another mark to get that. Rosario Lechiara, his final box.
And they'll have a respectable total and a losing cause, too. Both teams bowl well, but just wasn't Rosario Lechiara and Shelly Borowski's day.
A 120 in the third string. 364 for 3. But Mike Sargent and Mary Ligenza will be going on to the finals.
Bring it in, baby. Bring it in.
No problem. That's 5 in a row now for the team.
Big one. Come on.
Here's the replay and cluster 5 on the right hand side this time. Oh boy.
Big 9 Phil.
9 pin drop. 4 pin left for the spare.
Six marks in a row. 8 this string, and that's Mike Sargent's 11th mark. And an 8 drop and a 154. Well, they just missed the 150 in the second string, but they got it this time with a string of 6 consecutive marks coming down to the end, and the totals will go up, and they're pretty impressive for our winners this week. Mike Sargent and Mary Ligenza with a 422 and Rosario Lechiara and Shelly Borowski with a 364. We'll be back to talk to the bowlers and tell you a bit more about next week's semifinal when we return. Don't go away. WCBC Pro Bowlers Classic. Our first semifinal is complete, and our runners-up in this afternoon's match, Rosario Lechiara and Shelly Borowski. Rosie, just not a 450 this time.
Well, we're just going to get together this time, and the other team, they got together to score.
They really bowled well, Mike and Mary.
Bowled very well.
Shelly, things were kind of looking troubled for you at the beginning. You were getting splits all over the place, and then you finally got it together in that third string.
That 5-7-10 will haunt me. I've never seen so many, but I got my act together, and the last two spares in that last string made me feel a lot better.
Well, congratulations to the both of you for appearing on the Classic. It takes a lot of work just to get this far, and we have checks for you to split $500 for your semifinal appearance, and we hope to see you both again on the program real soon. Thanks for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, Rosario Lechiara and Shelly Borowski are runners-up for this afternoon's program. And now we're going to have Mike Sargent roll one ball for us for our home contest jackpot, and the jackpot right now stands at $20, so we hope you have your cards in. If you don't, remember, it's Sandy's Bowling Lanes, Route 28, Windham, New Hampshire, 03087. And be sure and include your name and address and a number from 1 to 10, and if your number matches the number of pins that drop, Mike and Mary, come on up, as we'll try and pull a 7 out of the box here. Had one, and I dropped it. And it is not a match for Kay Fair, or Farr, I believe it is, from Lawrence, Mass. She picked 6, so Kay, you'll be receiving a TB50 NHCBA desk pen. Right now, Mike Sargent and Mary Ligenza, congratulations on your win. You both really had it going today.
Yeah, Mary was bowling real well. I think what a lot of people don't see is Rosie and his partner weren't getting any breaks, and they still hit 360 for me. That's Super Bowl, and we were getting them all, and that's all that counts.
Mary, another good week for you, too. Everything seems to go well for you.
I guess I was lucky today.
Well, next week, or I should say in 2 weeks, you two will be back to face the winner of next week's match for the $1,000 grand prize. So we'll see you in 2 weeks.
Let's hope it goes just as good.
All right. Mike Sargent and Mary Ligenza are our winners in this semifinal, and we'll see them again in a couple of weeks. Next week, Dan Murphy, we will have our second semifinal match. It'll be Jack Ray and Sharon Rawson going against Mike Poulin and Carol Downey.
Both teams bowl extremely well in their first win, their first matches, so I expect another real tough match next week.
All right, be sure and join us next week. We'll be here at Sandy's with that semifinal of the WCBC Pro Bowlers Classic. Until then, for my partner Dan Murphy and the whole TV50 sports crew, Doug Brown saying good afternoon from Sandy's. See you next week.